Hello and good morning to Bratton at War. The show is basically a three-part show. It's Operation Omega, which is obviously for the military side of our show under the MVT, and it's Step Back in Time, which brings in together all the sort of street life and goings on in the 1940s during the Second World War. We've also gone even further back with medieval archery at the far side of the field, so there's a concept of all sorts of aspects of battle throughout time. The show is set into a square, a bit like EastEnders really, and we've got four main streets. Feeder Road speaks for itself. It's food and drinks and all the sort of refreshments that you might need along that road. The top end is Victory Parade, and along that part of the square is all the military vehicles. On the other side of the arena is Gunner's Hill, and over there are a selection of all different kinds of vehicles and stands and trade stands. And then on the south side we've got the Blitz Street, which is a street that's come together of a number of people who've got similar interests, and we display all the sort of household effects and the street life of the 1940s. And the show today is also, hopefully if the weather improves, but a parachute drop. The reason that being is that the show is basically to celebrate the 70th anniversary of Market Garden, that's at Arnhem. And just across the way, quite a large number of paratroopers left the nearby airfield at Keeble for that particular drop. So we're hoping the parachute guys will drop in today to commemorate that 70th anniversary. And sitting next to me is Bob Conway and his wife Gwen. Bob is a veteran of the D-Day landings on the 6th of June 1944. He landed at Arromanche, and I'm sure he'd be delighted to tell you a little bit of the history of that. Over to you, Bob.
Hey, Bob. Well, it's difficult to say, really. Well, I was 18 and scared, as usual. I wondered what we were going to get into, but we landed. And just carried on from there. You just had to keep going. And it was a young company we was in. We was all the same age, transport company. And then we was on ammunition and petrol, and sometimes food to take up to wherever they were, wherever it was needed. I was 18 at the time, only a lad really. But there, we got there, and I'm so proud that I'd done it. I wanted to do it, I'd done it, made sure I'd done it. It's great.
I'm Nemi, and I do civil defence, which is that side, and my grandpa does the police warden.
Alright, so what have you got to show us?
This is what most of my like display, like what the civil defence people would have, and and on this side is my grandpa's display with
all his
memory, Billy.
Oh, okay. So, all sorts of lovely things.
Yeah.
Strange, rare things. There's some police things there as well.
Yeah. So.
All right. Okay. I'm a track, you don't see those very often.
No. Gosh. So.
Oh, and an ARP team.
Yeah. He's Mr. Pike.
Yeah.
From. If you're wondering why we called him Pike, because of the. And this little guy, Howard, is Jamie, and we act as a lost dog.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Lost?
Yeah.
Aww.
Except for when it's lunchtime, isn't he? In it, Jamie. So.
Are we filming? Oh, it's video.
Ooh.
Woo! Yes!
Oh, they're comfortable.
From
Fantastic.
Lady She. And we have the beauty salon.
Sorry,
I'm going to hide the cup.
Sorry.
We have the beauty salon today. So we're doing hair and makeup, hair and some lipstick a girl has to have. And we have the girly tent with some jewellery and accessories for sale. She Unique Vintage from Cirencester.
Okay, well, the display you see here at the moment is the British and German, how they faced each other at Dunkirk in 1940. There's weapons, equipment and uniforms that they were using, and we talk to the public and show them the differences and the performances of their and the tactics they used at the time. We've been collecting since, I guess, early 80s, I was a young boy. And the group's been formed about 2 years ago.
Tommy and Jerry,
1940.
Oh, that's handy.
Basically, it's a Bedford fire pump. They were built in the start of the Cold War with Russia to give us fire cover and also mainly to transport or send loads of volumes of water all over the country in case the infrastructure went down. Say you had one city with no drinking water, these pumps can pump 900 gallons a minute through 6-inch holes and deliver vast volumes of water. They can go all day and all night, really, as long as you keep them filled up with petrol. Otherwise, they were primarily meant for that, for transporting water. They got a 300 gallon tank on board, which this one has got now. It's midships for emergency use. They carry an auxiliary pump, which is the little one here. It's called a featherweight pump, but you need four strong people to lift it. He will pump from open water 300 gallons a minute, which you can use to feed these machines or to feed anything else, or actually put hoses on to do it. As you can see in that locker, you've got all the what we call a wrecking gear. You've got standpipes there for getting onto the main water mains. In this locker here, we've got the a foam making branch, which is used from the main pump on the water tank, and a canister of foam making fluid. This is what they call a ground monitor. That's if you've got quite a large fire. You just put that on the ground, and it's heavy enough to stay there on its own when you put the hoses to it, one of these hoses here, and you can just leave that one to go. You've got other branches here, hand controlled branches, different sizes. This is the 6-inch hose, which is used for a large supply of water. That's if you say you want to shift water a lot, which it goes on the other side of the vehicle. This is 45mm hose. Rescue ropes. These are general purpose ropes, the blue ones. These here are kept in new condition for rescue work only, if you've got somebody rescuing. And then on the back, of course, is the main pump. It's a Sigmund centrifugal pump. He will deliver 900 gallons a minute. And when you're going from open water, obviously you use these links on the bottom row, 6-inch, onto here, into a lake or a river, and then the delivery hose comes away again, and you can deliver that at 100 pound pressure for firefighting. The other hose is on the top, the 4 inches for that small pump on the side. The wheels are for the pump on the side as well. The other lockers on this side are different hose again. They're what we call 75mm hose for bigger deliveries again. That's the 6-inch takeoff for when using the big 6-inch hose. Six-inch hose again, but drain rods this time in here. And minute you say drain rod, you think of drains, but it isn't. It's for chimney fires and things like that. Which drain rods fit on the end of this stirrup pump match in here, and that's a star head there. Water shooting out in all directions, and when you got it on, it's slide up the chimney, and obviously you wouldn't use the main pump because you have too much water flooding people's houses out. So that's it. Yeah. There's lots of kit on here, it'd take too much to explain it. Yeah, this is my Bedford fire engine, XWD. I bought it on eBay 6 years ago and imported it back into this country from Ireland. A chap in Ireland bought it off the MOD. It's done nearly 5,000 mile now, but when I bought it, it had only done 2,500. It's a very sound vehicle and starts on the button every time. Well, I'm very proud of it, to be honest.
It's 1967. It's the Ford Anglia 105E. I expect a lot of you have seen him on hard leads. Now, this is come from Kent, because it was with the Kent Force, but all the forces over the country have them, and they are the original Panzer car, just because of the colours on the mark here.
Little sister, don't you? Little sister, don't you? Little sister, don't you kiss me once or twice and say it's very nice and then you run? Little sister, don't you do what you do?
So then they made these up instead.
During the Second World War, the girls were given these udders to practice on. And we made some, but they broke, so we're just fixing them so that people can come and have a go at milking Daisy our cow.
That's paperwork, they're taking a milk cow around, which means goodness knows what paperwork by the Ministry of Ag.
Oh yeah. See, I can't do poles. I can do
roads. Hey, no, you're leading.
I'll fly over, don't worry.
We have a nice round of applause for all our keen volunteers who have decided to come into the arena. Fair play to them. Right, Lieutenant Ogborn has got the proud privilege of bringing our VIP, Mr. Bob Conway, to come along and inspect the troops for us.
Yeah, I didn't come down. Come to see you. Thank you. Thank you. I think so. I surrender. Is that all right? Shake hands. Very smart.
Thank you very much, everyone.
Thank you.